make a U-turn if possible.
Okay, we're around Green Bay, heading off towards Milwaukee and points north along Door County soon. We're still going southeast yet.
And this is a bridge over what?
I don't know. It is. We're on I-43 and I-87 is coming up. We're in Green Bay. This is where we're at.
Take WY-54W-57's charge in Bay, and then keep to the left in 950 feet. Keep to the left on WY-54 East WY-57 North Sturgeon Bay. Continue on this road for 44 miles.
Oh yeah, that'll get us there. We're in Oconto, Wisconsin. That's a stoplight. Heading for Sturgeon Bay, Door County, Wisconsin. On our way to the ferry docks up north. Beautiful day so far. The land of cherry pie. straight down. Sister Bay.
Maybe this was the picturesque part.
Look, deer. Left side. Another one on the right. Two more.
In 2 miles, go straight on Washington Island Ferry.
It's 9 deer that we've come across now.
Speed warning.
Fast?
I don't know.
Or you have more fun.
Yeah. That's got the idea. Your steering wheel. Look, there's a picture of a boat up here.
In 1/4 mile, go straight on Washington Island Ferry. Speed warning. Straight on Washington Island Ferry.
Would that be a Ken Coyne's cousin of mine? Can't wait to get there.
Alright, so we have 2 adults, a car, and a 15 to 20 foot trailer.
Most places want the credit cards.
Well, you know, they charge it.
Yeah. And how many puppies are back there?
There's two. Two little guys.
Little poodles?
A toy and a miniature.
Alright, on your credit card.
Do they cost anything?
their bike.
Thank you.
too, huh?
Yeah. This is GPS.
Oh, GPS?
Yellow is Plum Island. We're staying in this lightest blue here to go around.
And your name is?
Bill Jurgensen.
Bill Jurgensen. Got it. Fishing boat anymore.
No.
Yeah, we know why.
I thought I was going to die the last time I got on that thing.
Yeah, I rode it a few times too. I was freaking up.
Were you? It wasn't just me then, huh? Maybe it's the way he drives it. I don't know.
Yeah, believe it or not, yeah.
If it's
yeah.
rough enough, it's I was good one time and he was sick, so.
Really?
Kenny was sick.
Oh, I need to hear that story.
He was eating a piece of pie and I said, why don't you? You should give me that piece of pie because you're not going to keep it down very long.
Oh, we left some behind today, or?
You did?
Okay. Earlier.
Oh, early.
Now, is this Detroit Harbor?
Thank you.
Thank you. We are on Washington Island, and it's 12:44 Denver time.
Look at the lineup.
2:44 Washington Island time.
All these people want to get on the ferry.
We probably put 5 miles on the GPS, but not on the car because we came across on the ferry.
They may not make it on the ferry.
Body works. Over there. What if they got a gas station?
Oh, I think you're fine.
Do you have any dentists on the island?
Line Road, CRW. Turn left on connecting road and then turn right at 250 feet.
There's nobody left out here. There comes Ken of the Ken Coin Collection with the potatoes and onions.
Just potatoes.
Just the potatoes.
Yeah, Ken, down at the house, George said he can't wait to go fishing with you again.
Yeah.
I'll bet.
He was already asking if I had room.
Dream on.
Kenny,
Okay, that's the potatoes. I understand they'll go about 15 minutes, then they'll bring out the second colander full of onions. Put that in, that'll go about 15 minutes. Then they bring out the fish. He's filleting the fish now, making boneless fish steaks. That'll take about 6 minutes total, and then they haul it all out and plate it up, put some homemade bread with it. The KK Fisk restaurant also features fresh lawyers. Those are fish, the heart's in the ass, that's where they get their name. Across the way we have an electric windmill generator. That thing gets to going so loud you can hear it for quite a distance away. We're visiting the Sunset Resort located on the southwest part of the island. It's a very windy day here today. Nevertheless, the view is fantastic, especially at night when the sun goes down over the horizon. And the food in the restaurant is just great. We'll be eating here tomorrow morning, Sunday morning, sharing breakfast with Elsie and Mike Langford.
Destination on the right side in 800 feet.
here we are, leaving the Sunset Resort, only to return tomorrow for breakfast.
Left on Lobdo Point Road, CRW, and then approaching destination on the right side in 800 feet.
How fun.
How dangerous.
George with his
smile.
This is as close as I come.
We're buddies.
You are.
Yeah.
Well, this is a video, so you can move around.
Don't worry.
What kind of moves are you going to put on in there?
And this would be Elsie.
You yeah, just broke your camera.
Elsie Langford.
Indeed.
Daughter of Olga.
Say what?
Daughter of Olga.
Oh.
He's narrating.
I thought he was saying died of pneumonia.
And this would be Mike. I could have said that. This would be Mike. The Mike Langford, right?
Yes.
My ears don't work as well as they
Well, you're going to break the camera for sure.
And this is?
Hazel.
Hazel Nelson?
Hazel, yep.
Gotcha, Hazel. Pig roast tonight at the Ken Coyne Collection. There's the Roost and a few other restaurants. I gotta video this and make the folks back home jump.
Alright.
These
are our smart That's good enough?
Oh, yeah.
That's perfect. That is absolutely good job.
Well, I don't know if it's perfect.
It is perfect.
It is.
Oh, you find that shirt?
No.
The illogical chart in the house.
Start the chart.
It's
got
going
the
on.
Chart.
Just like,
oh, good.
Yes.
We'll be back to visit.
Jesse's mother brought him in.
You know how to lure him back.
Sure it is. I know lots of things in the
Hey, we were talking to Elsie today.
Yeah.
She knows lots of stuff.
Yeah, no way.
That's Grandma.
Okay.
Mother.
Nice to meet you.
The gentleman over there, sitting in the chair.
Just lay here. Just lay here and I'll resolve things. You want me to scoop you up something?
Yeah, yeah.
That's
I need cream.
That's not a big deal.
This, oh, this is what?
This is he went off
and
No, they didn't
get
to
call it. What do they do?
So they all have to walk out of the
One
bus.
Of us.
One will have to walk out of the
Are we marking these on the square?
Not much money.
You're okay, Casey. I know who you are.
Yeah.
How you doing?
This is the pig roast dinner. There's Bill over there, Nadine,
what?
Caroline, and Mary.
Tell him.
I said, I hope you asked the other guy and got a good education.
I got you when you're looking your best. Let me see, we have Mike here, and we got Elsie over here. Fantastic. This is the restored island dairy where all the farmers that used to run dairy cows on the island would bring their milk. It was sort of a co-op. Then they would turn the milk into the milk and the cheese and other products for distribution or sale. Now it's the lavender shop.
Tom Johnson. Nets are being lifted. A bigger one is taken in with a big net. And here the nets are showing the air and the engine is up. This is really nets to dry when the netting was cotton. With monofilament and nylon now, they no longer need to bring the nets in.
That would be Mary Jorgensen's father or grandfather? I think grandfather. Belies the depth of the building.
Yeah, right. Yeah, a lot of people are surprised when they walk in and see it's a lot bigger than they think.
Yeah.
So where are you from?
Colorado.
Oh, came up in the mountains in Colorado.
What's a
golden eagle?
Yeah.
It looks kind of like an immature bald eagle. The bald eagles don't get their white head, you know.
Eagle.
Yeah.
I'm sure there are bigger ones.
He's a big fella.
Yeah. Except for Harold's. Harold does good work too.
Yeah.
Okay, we go down here and we see.
This is the road to L.P. Ottosen's residence back in the early 1900s. Coggy. I knocked the antenna over again. Walter Ottosen's farmhouse in the rain. This is the Lars P. Ottosen house, located down the Little Lake Road. I believe it's currently under ownership by Layman's. Nice view of the waterfront there. And a beautiful old barn. Boy, would I like to see what was in there. I guess I better put my antenna up.
So Celia Ottosen Coyne went to school here. What is it now?
It's the Art and Nature Center.
Well, that's better than the Habitat for Humanity.
LP Ottosen, June 11, 1842 to July 10, 1924. His second wife, Christine Ottosen, born July 3rd, 1853, and passed away on April 22nd, 1943. Northport. Thank you. about ready to disembark. Dog in the front. Last one on, last one on. This is where the garbage truck tried to get off. Ah, there goes the going across the other way traffic.
Thank you.